Graphing one. Graphing 5x minus 2y less than or equal to 6. Lots of different ways we can go about this. My recommendation was that we make it look like y equals mx plus b, slope-intercept form.
So it'd be negative 2y over on the side of the line.
What's that?
No. Can you speak clearer?
And
y.
More specifically?
Over where?
Over where?
Just write 2y.
Okay, I'm going to write
2y. Negative
2y. Negative 2y. It's an inequality, right?
Yeah, 5x.
Like 5x.
Are you supposed to put minus in there?
Negative 5x?
No, I don't know what are you going with negative 5x.
What is going on?
No, you're supposed to put inequalities down there. I don't know.
Equals? Less.
Less
than.
Alright, that's what I'm just gonna leave for everybody else.
Okay.
Plus
6.
Plus
6. That's 2. It's close. Okay, it's not, I mean, it's close to being halfway there.
Halfway there.
Okay,
so it's not negative 2. But it is.
Oh,
no,
you confused me, Kyler.
No, 6 would go first. Six
it's
would,
negative
6
5
would
x.
Go first.
It's
no.
Negative 5x.
It is negative 5x.
Oh, I told you.
6
there
would
we
go
got
first,
it.
Though. 6
we're halfway there.
X. How about that?
Okay, how do we get there? Subtracting 5x from both sides. Subtract 5x from both sides. And here we are, negative 5x plus 6. I like it looking like that because it looks like mx plus b.
But also,
stop making lots of noise and making it difficult for people who maybe want to follow along to follow along. Okay?
I'm trying to explain.
So now what do we do to get y by itself?
Divide by negative 2.
Divide by
negative
2 on every single one of them.
Yes, good point. What does it look like now?
Y
is
greater
than
oh, yeah, you gotta change the
sign. That's why?
Because you divide by negative 2.
Okay. Negative 5 divided by negative 2. As Kyle's reminding us, we have to divide every single thing by negative 2.
1.5.
Right, 5 halves.
1.5.
We're not going to write 1.5, especially not for a slope. It's not going to be very long.
Well,
session
with
decimals.
Minus
3, yes. 6 divided by negative 2 is a minus 3. Okay.
Wait, I got to copy this all down.
We've been doing that the whole time.
Yes. Molly isn't here.
Okay. So,
if Molly is.
So a quick reminder here, when we graph these inequalities, we get basically two parts. There's a line, Kyler. Where does that line come from? What's the line made of? It's made of points. Made of points, right? It's made of points. All those points have an x and a y. They're on the line. So if I take an x and a y, and I take a point from that line, it's x and y. And I put that x and y into the inequality. What happens?
Could
be
negative 3.
And
that y.
Not necessarily. You could be like there's an infinite number of possibilities for x and y. I mean there's. Special combinations, except when it's certain x or certain y, there's an infinite number of possibilities. If I take an x and a y from the line, and I put the x there and the y there, what's going to happen? Both sides are going to be what? Right? As opposed to not equal. And that's significant. Okay? The line, special collection of points, all those points, when I take the x and y, and plug it into the inequality, they are equal. Right? Both sides are equal to each other. Okay? So, that's where both sides are equal. Then there's this half, this blacked out. I like the term blacked out. What's it blacked out by? Points. No points, right? And these points are different from points on the line, because these points, when you plug the x and the y in, please face forward. When you plug that x and y into the inequality from the blacked out half, what do we get? What do we get on the in this inequality? Are both sides equal?
No.
Okay. They're not equal.
They're different points.
They're different points. One side is greater or less than. Okay.
Yeah,
so if it's from the blacked out half, then well. Then the inequality will be, the inequality can either be right or wrong, true or
right
false.
Right or wrong, or left or right.
So what will it be if I pick a point from the blacked out half and I put the x and y into the inequality, will the inequality be
true
or false?
It'll be true.
True or false?
It will be true, okay? So when I take a point from the blacked out half, I put the x there and the y there, well, whatever this is, the y will come out to be larger, right, because it's on the greater than side. Alright, so let's find that line. We can find the line from both sides being equal. If we write it as equal, it can help us jog our memory. So look at that. That's just the slope-intercept form of a line. Where negative 3 is what? What about the line is negative 3? The y-intercept is negative 3. And this guy here? Slope. We're going to go to the right 2. 5, which would put us right here. The right 2, up 5, which is right there. Those are 2 points, right? 2 example points, where by plugging the x and the y into this inequality, both sides will become exactly the same. Let me just show you, just so you can be sure, this point at 2, 2.
Yeah.
Put in the 2 for y. Put in 2 for x. 2 divided by 2 is 1, so we just have 5 times 1, which is 5. 5 minus 3 is?
2.
And both sides are equal, just like
yeah.
We were talking about. Okay, so all the points on this line make both sides equal. Is it okay for both sides to be equal in this case?
Yeah.
Yeah, we got this little equals 2 here, so yeah, it could be. So that means what kind of line do we draw?
Solid.
A solid line, not a dotted line, because it's okay if both sides are equal. So check, we found the line. We found all the points where the x and y, when we plug them into the inequality, make both sides equal. Now we have to find the half that's blacked out where it makes it not equal. Right? I showed you the what I would call the easy way. I'll show you another way in just a minute.
0, 0.
The way that I showed you was to pick, as long as 0, 0 is not on the line, pick 0, 0. It's pretty easier than 0 for x and 0 for y. So we put in 0, 0, let's pick another. 0 for y, equal to 5 halves times 0 for x minus 3. So 5 halves times 0 is 0, minus 3 is negative 3. Is this true?
Yes, because 0 is greater than
negative 3. So 0 is greater than negative 3. 0 is greater than negative 3, because it's farther to the right. So it came from this side, that point worked, right? So I must have picked it from this massive blacked out half of the plane.
So you feel that you feel it. It's always the left that works.
Again, my suggestion is that you not think left and right of the line, but above and below the line.
Would always be above the line if it works.
I mean, if the point that you picked was above the line and it worked, then the shading would be above the line. If you picked the point from above the line and it didn't work, then the blacked out half must be below the line.
Okay.
Does that make sense?
Yep.
Yeah?
I think it should be the other side because 0, 0 doesn't work.
No, it does. 0 is greater than negative 3. Right, we plug 0 in here and 0 right there. We get 0 is greater than or equal to, well, negative 3 is the only thing that's left. Right? You see what I mean? So it works. 0 is greater than negative 3. 0, 0 came from above the line, so we shade above the line. If it didn't work, we shade below the line. Okay. So that's method one. Method one for finding the blacked out half. Okay, method one is what I'd call a test point. If find a test for. Okay? Kyler and Clint?
Hot.
You need to stand outside because they're so hot.
Kyler,
can you cool off?
It's hot in here.
Is this Prince wearing?
I'm normal.
I'm not wearing a jacket.
I'm not wearing a jacket.
And this is dressing Prince problem.
Well, I think it's
just they have a weird metabolism.
I have a.
So method one is you pick a test point. Like 0-0 is a good one, as long as it's not in the line. A good test point is, you know, 0-0 is not available. Another point where at least one of them is 0. 0 for X and 0 for Y. Nice. Alright. Here's method two I'm going to teach you. And method two is the reason why I keep telling you not to think to the left of the line and to the right of the line, but above and below. Above and below. Okay, so now I'm going to reveal to you why I keep reminding you to think of it as above and below instead of left and right. So when we write the inequality this way, in this y equals mx plus b, and the y on one side and mx plus b on the other side, is because, when you write it that way, then y is by itself, right?
Mm-hmm.
That's the basic idea. We've done that quite a few times. You get y by itself, so it's in slope intercept form. Now, y, what would you say about y on the graph? Just any old graph, y is always, in what way is it different from x?
One side of it.
One of them's going up, and
the
other one's
going
up.
Right?
Horizontal and vertical.
Horizontal and vertical. And which goes vertical?
Y.
Y does, right? X and Y. So Y is vertical.
Mm-hmm.
Got that locked in your brain so far?
Vertical.
Y is vertical. Okay. That's the key to why I keep telling you think of it as above the line and below the line. Because Y is vertical and Y is by itself on this side. Okay? Well, the Y value of any point that's going to work in this inequality, the y value needs to be greater than this step over here. Okay? Y needs to be greater than this step over here. And y is vertical. Y is vertical. And in the vertical dimension, where do you find greater numbers? You find them up here? You find them down here?
Up
here, right? Up there, that's where a million is. That's where a billion is. That's where a trillion is. Big, big numbers. You're going to find small numbers, go down.
1, 2, 3.
Small numbers like negative 1 million, negative 1 billion, negative 1 billion. Those are technically small numbers, right? Less than. But y, the vertical component, needs to be greater than the stuff on this side. Okay. If I just plug numbers in for x and figure out what y is and plot all those points, this is what I get, this line right here. All the y's that are bigger than that are above it. Above the points that are on the line. Let me give you a, tell you this in a slightly different way. So let's look at this point. We've already done this. We plugged 2-2 into the inequality, right? We plugged 2-2 into the inequality. What happened?
It made it equal.
Look at this right here. There it is. Just a reminder, that's exactly what we did right there. We plugged 2-2 into the inequality, 2 for x, 2 for y, and came out equal. Well, I'm going to pick another point so that the other side, that left side, comes out to be greater than, like it's supposed to. Well, what if I pick this point? Is that going to work?
No.
Nope, that's 2-0.
Wouldn't work. It wouldn't be
2-0. Wouldn't work because this would be 0, and 0 is not greater than 2. What about this one? 2-1. Would that work?
No.
Notice I'm picking points below the line on purpose to show you how they're not going to work. If I pick this point right on the line, we already discussed it, it makes it equal. Now I go right above it, 2-3.
That works.
See how that works? The y value is larger than the y value on the line, which the line is where they're all equal.
On the 2 is greater than or equal to 2,
mm-hmm.
Wouldn't y be on the greater than side?
It is.
So
y is on the greater than side, and that's what we want. We want the y to be greater than the other side. Okay. If I keep the x at 2, right, if I just keep plugging in 2 for x, but changing the y value, I'll find that I'll have to pick y values or points that have right? Y values that are larger than the y value on the line. On the line they're equal. Above the line the y value is greater, like it used to be. And below the line the y value is less than, like it don't want it to be. Kyle?
When you plugged in 2 for x and 2 for y, wouldn't you do 2 times 5 over 2 instead?
You could, then you get 10 over 2. 10 divided by 2 is 5, and 5 minus 2.
Yeah.
Or 5 minus 3, sorry, is 2.
10.
I did like the cross cancellation and just multiplying fractions and simplifying it all. And that's it. So this method 2 would be first you get y by itself, and if y is on the greater than side of mx plus b, if y is on the greater than side, then we look at the line and we're gonna shade where?
On the other side.
There are two sides to choose from. Yeah, we're gonna shade above. We're gonna shade above the line. Because we want y values that are greater than, and there they are up there, above any point that you're talking about. And now if y winds up being on the less than side of mx plus b, we're gonna shade down. We're gonna shade below, right? Because the smaller y values are down there, down towards the negative space. I don't want you to just memorize this. If I did, I would have just said it right from the beginning and not given you any explanation. If the explanation is important, your best bet would be able to, for you, to have the ability to explain that to anybody else. Sit down with them and they say, well, how does this above, below thing work? You say, well, look, y is vertical, and y needs to be greater. And this stuff gives you the line. You just plug in x and find y, that gives you the line. So the points that we're talking about need to be from up here.
Or y needs to be smaller.
If y needs to be smaller, then we need the points from down there.
Yes.
All right. Now, 44. So the facts that are laid out are that this drama club
needs to raise 1,500 dollars.
Hey, let's all just
let's
stop. Not helping. It's like a bunch of noise. All right, so they need to make at least $1,500 to cover all their expenses. They get their money from selling tickets, right? Let's say that they are going to sell X adult tickets. Those cost $10. Let's say they sell Y number of student tickets. They cost $6. All right, so let's talk about that $1,500. Okay? That $1,500. Let's put their goal is going to be over here, and their revenue, like the money they actually make from selling tickets, that'll go over here.
So 10 plus 6.
What's that?
No.
Revenue. Of course. Revenue. There we go. Okay. And here is
10 plus
their kind of their goal. Right? So their revenue, what's the relationship between the money they make and the number 1,500?
Oh, they need to make that to cover the cost.
Just 1,500?
Yeah.
Or
1,400. What?
I don't know what you're talking about. Let me take it over.
Do they need to make 1,500?
Yes.
Could they make $1,501?
Yeah.
Would it be good if they made $1,499?
No.
No.
So they need to make 1,500.
Or more.
Okay, so the amount that they make needs to be greater than or equal to 1,500. I'm not looking for it. Let's work up to it together, okay?
I know I was going to give you the X and the Y.
That's why I keep stopping you from talking. All right. So they're going to sell some adult tickets and some student tickets. So let's say they have here a big pile of money from the adult tickets and a big pile of money over here from the student tickets. They're going to take those dollar amounts and do what with them?
Yeah, we'll buy them.
Let's say you sell X, here you go, your time's shining, Tyler. You sell X adult tickets.
10X.
10 times X. Let's just talk about this real quick. If X were one, if there were one adult ticket, 10 times 1, they made $10, right?
Mm-hmm.
Two adult tickets, they made $20. Okay, that seems to be worth it. Plus,
6Y.
6Y, for the same reasoning, 6Y seems to make sense.
Mm-hmm.
All right, so that's part A. Part A says write an inequality to represent the situation.
Then divide by 6.
Why are we dividing by 6? Okay.
6 will get you 150, 150,
250.
You know what I mean? So. 250 is going to be up on the top. And that's when you divide by 6. 150 divided by, 1,500 divided by 6. 250 would go up top, okay?
Up top.
For the Y. 250 would be Y.
The letter B. Right, but
yeah.
Your approach maybe is not great for every single person.
My approach is good for every person.
No.
So let's try and get Y by itself, which is, I think, what Tyler is getting to. But first, let's subtract 10x from both sides. So we get 6y is greater than or equal to negative 10x plus 1500. And then, Tyler, we would what?
No.
Oh, that's going to pop. Okay, so what would we do next to get Y by itself?
Then you divide by y. I mean 6.
Yeah, divide by 6. Everything by 6.
210 divided by 6 equals something.
Oh, sorry, 1500. So negative 10 divided by 6 is negative 5/3. I think we can divide them both by 2.
250.
X plus 250. Is that? Negative 5/3 x plus 250. Now it looks like y equals mx plus b. Slope intercept form.
Yeah.
Where this is what?
The
y-intercept.
Okay, I like
250, 100, 250, 200, 250.
250 right there, and then 150 right there. On that.
Now you might as well have left it back here.
Yeah. Or you could have just left it like that.
If I wanted to figure out where I should put a point on the x-axis, I want to do it like this. Put in a 0 for x, and you'll find a 250 for y. Put in a 0 for y, divide by 10, you'll find 150 for x.
Yeah.
Okay. You had to do this, which is not a great way of figuring out where the x-intercept is. But now that we do know where the x-intercept is, we can put a point right there, 50, 100, 150.
I'm going to put it up one of this way. And now it's going to be, since it's greater, y is greater.
Y is greater.
So then it's going to shade it in this way.
Shade above.
Shade it in towards the east.
No, not to the east, to the north. Above. Not to the right. Above. Okay. Okay. Y being greater tells you nothing about left or right. It's always above if y is greater. Low if y is less.
Tyler, why are you obsessed with arguing?
I'm not.
Yeah, you are.
Yeah, you are.
I'm terribly dead.
Tyler, just stop arguing. Shut up. Everybody, want to call me out?
Confused.
Tyler, I'm going to call
Tyler,
you out.
Just thank you.
I like your last name.
Don't touch my stuff.
I'm calling.
When you're dead, just let me know.
What?
See you. Sorry, Tyler.
Tell everybody else to quiet down.
Stop arguing.
Okay. So we shade above, as Kyler reminded us, y is greater than, so we shade above the line, right? Y is vertical, and the vertical numbers get bigger as you go up, so we shade up. So we graphed, and now they're asking us a question. 80 adults and 110 students attend the play. Does this cover the cost? I don't want to know yes or no, I want to know how can we figure out whether it covers the cost.
Oh. You just gotta put in 80 and 110.
Sure.
And then if that comes out, it's gonna be less than that, so no.
I guess what? Let's try and get there. You know, the humans. So,
yeah.
10 times. Well, X is the adults. How many adults? Is it 80 adults? 80 adults. So 10 times 80.
Plus
6 times 10. That needs to be greater than or equal to 1500. So we just see if it is or if it isn't. 1500 plus 660 see if that's greater than 1500. 660 plus 800 is 1460, which, since this inequality is, what would you call this inequality?
False.
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 Well, no, that combination of adult and student tickets does not work, so they don't cover their costs.
You go down.
They need to get either more students or more adults. What does this point represent right here? This is the point 0, 250.
All adults, 0, 150.
All adults?
All students.
It is all students, right? X is the number of adults. And how many adults do you see there?
Zero.
But if we look at this guy here, it's 150, comma, zero. That's zero what?
Adults.
Zero adults. Wait, zero what? Zero students. All adults. Which ticket costs more?
The adults.
Right? So you would need to sell fewer adult tickets to like make up all that money. Does that make sense?
Uh-huh.
So it makes sense that the smaller number, 150 as opposed to 250, right, is just what it would be if you sold, you know, just adults to take to play, which would be weird.
Yeah.
Just all adults came to high school play. Okay.
Not unless it's an adult.
Any questions?
A high school program.
I mean, yes, parents are going to show up. Also, some students.
Go ahead and
be
there.
Not all students.
I'd be out.
Let's put everything away.
Well, we can't have a homework review after this.
It's been a weekend. It's been a weekend.
Just kidding.
All right.
It's a solution.
Forward?
Yes.
Oh. Time to you, Kyler. Both feet underneath the writing surface of your desk. Completely not what's happening. We're wasting our time. How do we test to see if this ordered pair is a solution to this inequality? Kyler?
Plug in 3 for x and negative 5 for y.
Got it. That's exactly right. Negative 2/3 times 3 over 1. And whether you multiply this together or you cancel that 3, so here you get a 1. And a 1. Same. Negative 2 times 1 is negative 2, minus 3, negative 5. And then, oh, it's good, right? Negative 5,
it's
negative 5.
No,
I screwed up.
It's not a solution because...
because it's not equal to.
There is no equal to. This is not acceptable. It does not stand for it. It's not a solution.
Did you say yes?
I'll do this one.
Guys, I'm going to say that our understanding of productivity would come up like a good 15% if we did less talking over each other and random commenting. Okay? Crazy.
You could do 0, 1, or 1, 1.
That y intercept.
Then go over 8, not 5.
8, not 5. Over 8.
Oops.
There, up 5. Puts us there.
Did that wrong too.
Cool. So let me graph this line, what kind of line?
Straight line.
Straight.
Oh, black. Black line. Dotted.
Dot?
Not dotted.
No, not dotted.
What
is
dotted?
Line?
I
line.
Said dotted.
Line.
Okay. So I think when people say straight, they mean not dotted.
Black. Yeah, but
filled
a normal
in,
line.
Solid.
Be a yellow line.
A solid
standard
line.
Floor model line.
A solid line.
Alright, now it's going to head this way.
Which way?
That way,
up,
up, up.
Up, up, up.
Yeah.
Up, again. Above and below, not right and left. Above, below,
like
not right and left.
But what if we went straight up and down? Because then it would only be left and right.
Okay, well, let's talk about it. That's a good question.
Would it be going down?
Yes, the y is greater. Y is vertical, right? It's an up and a down kind of a thing. Where do the big vertical values come from? Down? Where are big y values found?
Up.
Over there. Not down here.
Up.
If we shaded to the right of this line, we'd actually be shading below this line. We'd be going infinitely down, 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 down. Very, very small y values. We want big y values, larger, greater y values. They're up here. Right?
Mm-hmm.
Up here, not down there.
Yeah.
Quint?
So you don't have to actually plug in the numbers.
Not to keep that in mind, you think, oh, okay, y is by itself. That's an ID because I know that if y needs to be greater, then I shade above. If y needs to be less, then I'll shade below.
Oh, okay.
If I were to try a point like 0, 0, I'll just find out, like, in this case, 0, 0 will not work. Shade to the other, you know, shade above. So the question was, what if it's a vertical line? And the quick answer is, if I have a vertical line that I'm graphing, then it's of the form x equals. There's no y involved. Okay, so then it would be left and right, because x is left and right. Right? So if we had x is greater than 4, well, we graph the line x is equal to 4 first, which is here, 1, 2, 3, 4, it'd be dotted because it's not equal to. And since x needs to be greater, greater x's are choosing the right and the shade to the right.
Okay.
Well.